Hello and welcome to Newsclick. Today we're going to be talking about the leading nuclear energy supplier, Westinghouse, which has filed for bankruptcy in US, and what are the impacts it's going to have on the nuclear industry. For this, we have with us Prabir Purkayastha, Newsclick chief editor and also an energy expert. So the leading nuclear reactor manufacturer, Westinghouse, has filed for bankruptcy in US. How is this going to impact the nuclear industry globally and in India?
The nuclear industry has two major problems. A, the cost overruns keep on growing, mainly because as we learn more and more about nuclear power, we seem to need more and more protection, we need to see more and more engineering changes to be made, and as a consequence, the cost goes high, as well as you get what are called time overruns. So, nuclear projects, wherever they are, whether they are Areva doing a set of projects in Europe, or it is Westinghouse doing a set of projects in the US, both have seen very high cost and time overruns. So, as a consequence, both for the companies who are building these nuclear power plants, the construction companies, Westinghouse, which was the reactor supplier, or the ones who are going to own these companies, both of them get into a lot of financial difficulties. And this is also today, coupled with the fact that you have a lot of gas available, the hydrocarbon price, the gas and oil prices have fallen dramatically, and particularly gas prices in the US are such that nuclear power really cannot compete against it. We also have what are called renewable power, solar being the prime example. Wind also is another of the renewables which have seen considerable development recently. All of it show that there is a continuous loss of competitiveness of the nuclear industry vis-a-vis other energy sources. So, really we have two sides of the coin. One side, the cost of nuclear energy is rising. Other side, the cost of renewables are dropping and dropping drastically, including the cost of non-renewables like gas, which have also dropped. So, we are seeing really nuclear power not being competitive. This is something that we had warned well ahead of its time in India itself, that this is not going to work. The worldwide, this has been a continuous set of messages given by different set of experts. Unfortunately, nuclear industry, which is a very powerful lobby because also backed by a whole set of political forces, have disregarded the clear evidence of this and has pushed this argument because of climate change, because of carbon emissions being high in terms of impact on the global climate. Therefore, nuclear should be brought back. I think this is the end of that story.
So, does that mean that the nuclear renaissance and nuclear power industry revival that has been talked about is coming to an end? It's over.
It's clearly over. You can see what is the impact, for instance, on the two major nuclear reactor suppliers in the West. One was France, Areva. If you remember France's history, it had at one point 80% of its energy needs being met by nuclear power. It had a very strong nuclear industry, which created this nuclear reactors. It invested a huge amount of money in this. Areva for the last 8 to 10 years has been struggling to build one nuclear reactor in Finland. And in fact, the project has seen such huge overruns that now the construction companies again, and Areva and Siemens, who have all involved in that project, as well as the owners of the plant, the Finnish electricity utility, are against each other in courts, who is responsible for the losses. It's a huge cost and price of cost overrun. The cost of the plant has increased by almost 3 times. The cost of electricity has gone, as a consequence, it go up really again almost by 3 times. And the time overruns means that this project, which should have been on stream 4 years back, has not come on stream even today. So, this is Areva. You have General Electric, which is another major builder of nuclear reactors. It's also pulling out of this business. Westinghouse was acquired by Toshiba about a few years back. And Toshiba thought that the nuclear renaissance means that with Westinghouse, and Westinghouse itself, the Westinghouse designs and built reactors are about 50% of the world's total reactor population. So, it was probably the most important player in the nuclear reactor business. So, Toshiba had acquired Westinghouse about a few years back in the belief that they would be able to hold at the pole position in the revitalized nuclear industry, which is thought would take place because of the climate change pushing carbon emissions on the back foot, therefore coal would not be popular. That really hasn't happened. And last, of course, we had the Fukushima disaster, which made also clear the dangers of nuclear plants, and not that they cannot be made safe, but the cost of making them safe is prohibitive, and consequence of not having a safe plant means that you could really open yourself out to huge losses, not just for 1 year or 2 years, but you could also create a condition where saving, for instance, what we saw in the Fukushima disaster, saving that area, being able to bottle up the plant, to be able to prevent radioactive fuel and waste from leaching into the sea and nearby waterways, underground water, this is really prohibitively high. So we are really seeing the consequence of the bad economics of nuclear industry, bringing it down. It's not that nuclear per se is something that we cannot do, or nuclear energy is something we cannot do, but the cost of doing it against the other forms, much safer, much lower in price today, particularly with wind and solar, I think nuclear is something that we need, technology is something we need to mothball. Interestingly enough, the two other nuclear vendors, apart from India, who are still active are the Russians and the Chinese. And they is because they are state supported, they also are able to do certain things that other players are not able to do because they are supposedly trying to survive commercially.
So if we talk about India, the left in India opposed the nuclear deal of which Westinghouse was a part. So how is this bankruptcy going to affect when it comes to India, the nuclear industry?
The US embassy has made a declaration after the bankruptcy of Westinghouse that this is not going to affect the India-US nuclear deal or the Westinghouse reactors in India. I think this is complete bunkum. It's very clear that this Westinghouse 6 reactors, which was really a part of the India-US nuclear deal, it was originally supposed to be built in Mithi Virdhi in Gujarat, then it was shifted to Srikakulam in Andhra. This has been going on for 10 years, these discussions. It's very clear that this deal is now going to hit the rocks. So I have no doubt that the Westinghouse project is dead, and whoever says it is not, things are going to continue, is really just whistling in the dark. This is not going to happen. It also brings out what the left had said. Left had not only opposed the India-US nuclear deal from the point of view of a strategic alliance which India was trying to seek with the United States and the consequence of that, but it also said that nuclear energy, particularly with imported reactors, is not going to be viable. We saw earlier the Areva nuclear reactors. The costs were going to be something like 28 to 30 crores per megawatt, which is at least six times that of coal or even today solar plants. So given those kind of costs, we had said, whether it's Areva or whether it's Westinghouse or it's a G reactors, that these imported reactors have no chance of being successful in India, and also they're untested reactors. And therefore, whenever you try to build untested reactors, the time and cost calculations go completely awry. If we want to see why Westinghouse is facing bankruptcy, primarily because it was trying to build reactors at fixed cost. They had taken fixed cost contracts both in Georgia and South Carolina, the two places where they're building two reactors each. And this fixed price contract that they had meant that whatever was the increase in cost, they had to absorb that. Now, the kind of changes required, the kind of cost escalation that took place meant that they are facing losses of the amount of something like $10 billion. And that's what finally Toshiba could not absorb. Now, if India wants to bail out Westinghouse, bail out the nuclear industry in the US, by taking those losses, reaching not fixed price contracts, but variable price contracts, then it's theoretically possible for Westinghouse to still survive or at least continue the Indian contracts. But I think Indian people are not going to be so stupid that they will allow this to happen. It's also clear that the liability laws we had in the country, again, left had worked very hard in the parliament to get this liability laws, which actually puts the responsibility of accidents, etc., faulty equipment on the nuclear supplier, nuclear supplier's liability, which the United States opposed and the United States companies opposed, that is what held up for a long time this contract from taking shape, which is what is saving us today. In fact, only in 2017, that US and India tried to absorb the liability of the supplier onto the Indian government, which is what the Modi government really did. But unfortunately for Westinghouse, it's come too late.
Thank you very much for joining us. And this is all the time we have for Newsclick. Keep watching us.